We're going to look at atoms to multiverse. You want to find the smallest structures and the largest structures in the universe. So let's take a look. We start by looking at the atoms. But in the atoms, we have probably the smallest structures we're going to find in the universe. And that would be the electrons. The electrons are super tiny. They might not even have any size. But we know that atoms have size. And there is approximately 100 trillion atoms in a human cell. Now, there's approximately 100 trillion of these cells in a human body. So there's quite a few atoms in a human body, approximately 100 trillion times 100 trillion atoms in a human body. When we look at the largest structures, they're at least hundreds of times bigger than a human being. We see large trees on Earth. Hyperion is probably the tallest tree in the world, 380 feet tall. And that's longer than a football field. Statue of Liberty and Big Ben in comparison. Then we look at the larger structures. We see lots and lots of trees now. And we see the Amazon. It's a large river in South America. When we look at this area from farther in space, we see a huge Amazon River basin. And this is more than 1,000 miles wide. Now we can see substructures. We can see smaller rivers coming off the Amazon itself and flowing down on the Earth. If you look at this farther out, we can see the whole Earth. Now, this is South America, and this is the Amazon basin that we were just looking at. In comparison, the moon is much smaller. We can put 50 moons inside of the Earth itself. The Earth is about 8,000 miles wide, the moon about 2,000 miles wide, about the size of the United States. When we look at the solar system where the Earth lives, we see that the Earth is a fairly small planet in the solar system. We can put 1,000 of these Earths inside of one Jupiter. That's the largest planet in the solar system. All these planets orbit the sun. The sun is the biggest structure in the solar system. You can put 1,000,000 Earths inside the sun. A bigger structure would be a bunch of stars like the sun. So the sun is a star and the Earth is a planet. The Earth in comparison is much, much smaller. But if you look at the sun a little farther out, we can see that the sun is just one of the stars in the Milky Way galaxy. And so we have plenty of neighbors. When we look at the galaxy itself, we see the sun is in just a spiral arm with millions of other stars. The entire galaxy has approximately 200 billion stars, and each one most likely has a planetary system like ours, the solar system. When we look at the universe at large now, we see multitudes of galaxies. These galaxies appear to live in clusters, and these clusters of galaxies are organized in the form of these threads. And so these threads are made of galaxies. And this, in comparison, is a clusters of galaxy that is the largest structure in the universe. Approximately 10,000 galaxies live here in this little tiny part. When we look at the universe from a farther out, the biggest vantage point that we see the entire structure now. The whole universe is made of these filaments or threads. They appear to be like human brain cells. Some of the human brain cells are connected like this with neurons. Now, when we look at the entire universe as a whole, we might find structures larger than our universe. Our universe may be just one of many. And all of these universes, including ours, are floating in something called a higher dimensional space. So our universe could have neighbors. This largest structure is called multiverse.